Welcome to Badgerclaw!
Miss Sally?
Yes, Lionel?
Why is it you think them stars is afraid of the sun?
Afraid?
You said they hide themselves until the sun is gone. And even though we can't see them in the daytime, they still out there waiting to come poking out once it gets dusky. I can see one or two now poking out, just as that sun there's a-slipping away. Now how's it come they do that?
I don't think they're afraid. The sun merely outshines them. It obscures them in its light.
Miss Dally?
Yes, Lionel?
If we was on the sun, would it be daytime 'cause we's on the sun? Or would it be nighttime 'cause we's on the sun, and there ain't no sun to look upon?
I think if we were on the sun, it would be the dusk of our mortal bodies.
I think if I was on the sun, I'd be strapped on tight and yelling out a mighty yee-haw. It's got to be moving pretty fast and zesty if it's circling the whole of the world in a single day.
I bet it's exhausting to be the sun. It ought to make like the moon and take a few days off every month or so.
Miss Sally, when we get your bunkhouse finished...
Boarding house.
Yes, boarding house.
Mm-hmm.
When we get your boarding house finished and we get all moved in, you think we'll still come out here sometime and watch them antelopes, even though we've got soft beds to slumber in?
I'm certain of it.
Miss Sally, you wouldn't be offended if I was to ask that Henderson farm girl to come along with us sometime to watch the antelopes graze and slurp. She don't have as many teeth as you, but I like her anyways.
I would be happy to have the company. Any friend of yours is a friend of mine.
Except Rabbit Joe.
He wasn't really a friend, though, was he?
He sure weren't.
Well, that's all behind us now. The law will catch up with him sooner or later.
I thought his poster was a pretty fair likeness.
Thank you.
She's got a bonnet with a yellow hem. She carries a basket of tasty treats.
Sometimes I think about chasing down that Rabbit Joe myself and getting that reward.
It would be dangerous.
I suppose it would. But I think somebody ought to go after him. Search the near and afar for him, from here to Timbuktu. Don't you agree, Mr. Old Man Wilson?
I agree wholeheartedly. I've got someone on it already. The outlaw Joe Gugoni's time is coming, I assure you. This country will never reach its potential with men like him in its midst, like fleas in a carpet.
He wasn't all bad. I feel a bit sorry for him, to tell the truth.
Typical.
There's men of his kind in Philadelphia as well.
Perhaps. But there will be one fewer here in this country before I leave it.
How long is you staying, Mr. Old Man Wilson?
We'll spend the summer here. We'll get the boarding house and the library and the various other establishments on their feet, and then hand them off to the permanent residents of the Badgerclaw community. Miss Applegate and I will return to Philadelphia in the autumn. Mr. Albert and his bride will be returning from their honeymoon in Europe at that time, and it will please the family to be reunited once more. But we'll be back to visit someday. Mr. Applegate has growing interest in this country. I need not elaborate on the details.
The Effie?
Yes. Anyway, we'll make it a point to check back in from time to time.
You really gonna leave after the summer's up, Miss Sally?
We'll see.
Sweet mercy. Oh, Willie.
I can't wait to live in a boarding house.
Badgerclaw is a Moon Lasso Media original production in association with A-Voice Productions and Sycamore Sky Studios. This episode was written and directed by Adam Vermillion, was produced by John Durbin, and stars Adam Vermillion, John Durbin, and Kate Isabella. Like us on Facebook at facebook.com/moonlassomedia and help keep us a missionating by subscribing, rating, and reviewing Badgerclaw on Apple Podcasts. Thank you for listening.